Kerala is a state that is reporting a worrying spike in daily COVID cases. It is for the very first time that Kerala has crossed the 40,000 cases mark. Kerala is currently reporting almost 42,000 cases on Wednesday, 41,953 to be precise. Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan has in fact raised concerns over the fast decrease in oxygen supply in the state. My colleague Sneha joins us with the very latest as far as Kerala is concerned. Sneha, it is a worrying story in terms of the spike in numbers, but also the Chief Minister there flagging the depleting oxygen reserves in the state.
Well, that's right, Rishika. In fact, Kerala is continuing to record the daily highest numbers in terms of COVID-19. And of course, Chief Minister writing to the Prime Minister for around 1,000 metric tons of liquid medical oxygen to augment the capacity or the availability in the state. But the district which is recording the highest in Kerala is Ernakulam district. It's the business capital, tourist hotspot, also a district with a lot of migrant workers from across states. And joining us right now is the district collector of Ernakulam, S. Suhas. Well, thank you for joining us, Mr. Suhas. First question to you. The visuals of what you shared on Facebook of the very high-tech COVID war room has, of course, gone viral. A lot of people appreciating that. But, Mr. Suhas, what has changed over the last 2 weeks? What's the kind of calls that you're getting, the responses that are being forced from the war room, or just the struggles? What has changed over the last 2 weeks as the cases have been surging?
Well, this time it has been a challenge compared to the first wave because of the mutant strain, and the cases have surged. So our main intention is to ensure rationality in allocation of beds and also monitoring of oxygen in all government and private hospitals. So what we do is we have a bed shifting system and also monitoring of oxygen of all the hospitals. So whenever we get distress calls, we try to see whether the person can be treated at home through telemedicine, or in case if he requires any treatment as to what kind of bed he needs to be allocated. If he's a category A patient, we have domiciliary care centers, we have first line treatment centers where he's allocated bed. In case if he's category B serious or if he's category C, then we allocate them to either government facilities which have oxygen or ICU beds, or we have a system of CASP in private hospitals. So we allocate the beds for in there. Mainly, our intention is to see that wrong people don't occupy the bed, and which results in the real who deserve it, they don't get it.
Right. Of course, the triad system is the crux of the allocations in Kerala. But Mr. Suhas, I also saw in that COVID war room the oxygen monitoring wing, and that's something which every district has started doing now. It may not be as high-tech as it is happening in Ernakulam, but how is it right now? How fast is this oxygen being used? Is the supply, is the availability a challenge, or is it the supply? You know, how to get it from the supply point to the to the hospital as demand rises. What is the situation in Ernakulam?
See, we have two sources. One is liquid medical oxygen, which comes from Kanjikode in Palakkad, and also a small portion of it comes from BPCL as well. And the second source of oxygen is oxygen cylinders. So what we have done here is the state government has given us a lot of support, and they are ensuring that we get our requisite quota of liquid medical oxygen. But the challenge is to ensure that even the small hospitals get the cylinders at the right time. So what the control room does is, in case we come to know that there is some shortage in smaller hospitals with respect to cylinders, we have a transportation mechanism which ensures that cylinders from our buffer stock is immediately sent there, and it ensures that there is no scarcity in that particular area. So we are sort of ensuring that no private or government facility runs out of oxygen even after informing us. So this is the system which is set up, and in real time basis all the hospitals keep entering what is the burn rate of oxygen, and how long do their stocks last. So accordingly, we can plan it and ensure that there is equitable distribution of oxygen.
Right, Mr. Suhas, we're totally out of time, but one question, and you'll have to answer this very quickly. A lot of panic calls saying that there are beds not available, oxygen ventilators not available. What's the situation? Quick answer, please.
Well, we are trying to ramp up more number of oxygen beds in the coming days. We have already started a facility near the source itself so that there won't be much of transportation issues. So once that comes up, I think that it will give us some kind of a cushion in the coming days. As I said, there is a lot of demand for beds, but it's about ensuring the right person gets the bed at the right time.